Hey everyone! Ilion Ascent Infinite Realm is a MMORPG game, and for all MMORPG games, guilds and guild system are a very important part of gameplay for many players. As you will see in the next few minutes, in Ilion, we have guild system developed on a really amazing way. Stay with me to find out all you need to know about guilds, guild benefits, guild coins and guild wars of Ilion MMORPG. Before we start, let me just say, subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that bell icon to see more new videos in the future. Let's check one of the guides here on official Korean servers of Ilion. Here in front of me, I have one of the posts from GM, and we have a guide here regarding guild system of Ilion. Don't be confused by a rough translation from Korean language to English language. You can see written here all the time, you will see also during this video, clan, wherever it is clan, yeah, this is a guild. So let's check what kind of guilds we will have in Ilion. Ilion's clans is divided into small up to 20 players, medium up to 40 players, and large up to 50 players clans, depending on the size of the clan. So this is rough translation from English language, like I said. However, it's very clear we have three types of clans, small up to 20 players, medium up to 40 players, and large up to 50 players. And I must say right now on the start, this is really amazing and this is really important. Why? Because I think these numbers are the way it should be. Because if you have like really huge guilds like 100 players, 200 players or more, I don't know really is that good for that game at all. On this way, you have, as you can see, small clans, small guilds, 20 players. Largest guilds are up to 50 players. That's really nice. On that way, there is no domination on one guild, specifically on the server. On that way, you actually can have few very strong guilds on the server, and that is kind of distribution of power. And I must say, I like that. So after that, here, we have a basic informations here, how to create and how to join a guild. Normally, you have here information. Please note that you can join a clan, a guild, from level 1, but you can create a clan from level 20. That's kind of natural, of course, that you cannot create a guild when you're level 1. Of course, you need to be some higher level. In this situation, they have put in Ilion that you need to be level 20 minimum to be able to create a guild. And here we have example of user interface, how it's looking when you search to join a guild and how to join a guild. And we also have a user interface here, example, when you have to create a guild. So when you are creating a guild, it will cost you 1000 gold in-game currency, and the guild name can, you can enter a guild name. It can have up to 16 characters. You have some additional functions here. And the most important thing I want to show you here, one of the amazing things which you will see in this video regarding the guild system, check this out. Tip clan attendance. Attendance check is activated when there are 10 or more clan members, including the clan master. Okay, clan is guild, obviously. Attendance can be checked from the day after joining the guild. When you complete attendance check, you can get gold in stages in proportion to the number of the clan members who have completed attendance. If more than 50% of the clan members are present, you can earn 10 clan founds per person. Okay, about this clan founds, this is actually in-game currency. It's written here, clan founds. We can translate this as some kind of guild coins, and you will get guild coins, imagine that, only for attendance check. Of course, you need to check in every day, and like it's written here, if more than 50% of guild members are present, you can earn 10 guild coins per person. So this is also kind of interesting twist, right? Because you need to have active guild. If you have like 30% or only 40% active members in your guild, you will not get any guild coins that day. So you will want, if you lead a guild, if you're a leader of the guild, of even if you are a member of the guild, you want to have active guild. And this is, I must say, for the start, something really interesting and really amazing. Further here, we have another amazing feature. I must say, When I was reading this post, I am really fascinated how they have developed all this guild system. It's really amazing. Check this out. We have guild missions. All guild members can earn 1,000 guild coins and guild experience by solving guild-specific missions. In addition, you can get Sephiroth experience as a personal reward. I will make a dedicated video, a specific video regarding this Sephiroth experience. It's completely, we can say, specific feature of this game, really beautiful feature of this game, but it's too much to talk about this topic, so I will make specific video in the future regarding this. Let's now focus on guild missions. Solve missions ranging from field boss hunts to PvP, dimensional exploration, guild wars, and arenas. Come on, this is really amazing. So many things which you will be able to do that guild missions and to take benefits to take that guild coins. And here we have a user interface example how it's looking when you are actually accepting and taking reward for your guild missions. And really important notification is below this picture. So let's read it. Since guild missions are tasks that our clan members participate, so all guild missions can participate in the resolve, you can get rewards if other guild members have completed without having to solve it yourself. Wow, can you imagine that? So basically, if some specific guild task, guild mission have been resolved by your guild member, not you, some other guild member, and you can take that reward. No problem, right? Because you're a member of the guild. So this is actually really amazing when you are making, when you are doing this actually guild missions, you are also benefiting, making benefit for other guild members, not only for yourself. So this is, I must say, really amazing thing. And here we have, of course, a short explanation what is clan found. I said to you, this is a rough translation from Korean language to English language. So these are kind of guild coins, in-game currency, and what for you can use these guild coins. So let's check it out, and I must say, this is really amazing. You'll see now. So we have here guild shop where you will be able to purchase different kind of items for that in-game guild currency. And there are two types of items you will be able to buy. Some items you can apply on your clan members, and some items, as you can see in this table, are individual. So let's check first this clan member, guild member items, which you will be able to buy and use on your guild members. First thing here, we have guild pager. When used after installation, the guild member who responded to the summon is moved to the guild pager location. Lasts 3 minutes, targets all channels in the continent. Wow, can you imagine that? You'll be able to summon your guild member somewhere on the continent. This is, I must say, absolutely amazing, really beautiful. Let's check next. Guild resurrection scroll. When used, resurrects a guild member in the state of deceased soul, resurrects up to 50 guild members within a radius of 20 meters. Life rate, resource 20%. Wow, again something amazing. So with this scroll, you'll be able to resurrect your guild fellow member. Another thing, I must say, check this out. Melody of Battle. When used, acceleration of guild member in a radius of 20 meters increases by 100. 30 seconds cannot stack. Okay, it's kind of logical it cannot stack, because come on, if it would be stacked, it would be a lot of acceleration, right? To your guild members. Again, something amazing in PvP, in Guild Wars, let's say. A recovery pulse generator. Install wave of recovery generator. Recover up to 30% of the HP of guild member within the range for 40 seconds. Again, something really amazing. Restore HP. So you put this pulse generator and in the radius, you recover 30% of the HP to guild member. Really amazing. Individual items which you are able to buy for this guild coins in-game currency are hate potion, damage increased by 10% for 30 seconds. However, it is impossible to recover vitality for the duration. Natural recovery is possible. Okay, this is nice. Vehicle energy recovery potion, 30%. 30% of the vehicle energy is recovered when used after boarding. Wow, also something really amazing. So as you can see in this table, come on, really amazing items you'll be able to buy for this guild coins, this in-game currency, and to use it. Let's check then this window before. It's showing that these guild items you'll be able to put in your inventory, and there is also special guild material storage. Then we have clan master privilege. Okay, so this is showing actually for the leader of the guild what can you do. This is user interface where you'll be able to make some rank, some adjustments regarding your guild members. So you can put different ranks inside your guild. Not only there will be right a clan guild member or guild leader, there will be some guild deputies also. Now we are going here to guild benefits, and I must say another amazing feature, check this out. So, guild leader will be able to research different kind of things, and there are different kind of categories, free categories, hunting, life and war, depending what your guild is up to, what is gold of your guild, and on that way all guild members will have benefit from that. So let's say that your guild is more into life skills, then your guild leader will decide to research that life skills and you will get benefits from that. And let's say that if you are more into war or into PvP, then your guild leader will research more the war thing, right? I must say this is something really amazing. Check this out. Then we have one feature of the game which I'm really happy about. Come on, check this out. Guild Wars. This is something I must say really, really amazing. Clan Wars or Guild Wars is content available only to members of level 35 or higher. Okay, that's kind of logical. Who have joined a guild. A raid of 10 players is formed within the clan, within the guild. The attack leader can apply for Guild War matching. So basically you need to apply, and when matching is over, you will be transferred to special instance zone where you'll be competing with some another guild, against some another guild. The goal of the game here is to collect 1,500 points, and if you do that, you have a win. So there are two types of, we can see here, this is user interface which is showing there are two types of guild wars. I'll not go into details regarding that because this is a rough translation from Korean language, so I don't want to say something wrong, some wrong information. Let's check which informations which we have for sure. So you need 1,500 points for victory, and here we have some screenshots. How is this Guild Wars area looking? Really nice. This is the map. So map have different bases, and basically you are gathering points which when you are capturing those bases. Of course you will need to do some PvP here because bases can be recaptured. On that way you will lose points and that other guild will get points. And this is, yeah, I must say this is a really amazing game. It's showing here some different features, like if you die there you will be able to resurrect on the nearby graveyard. I will put a link in the description below video so you can check these details for yourself later. But come on, can you see this? This is, I must say this is really amazing. I cannot say to you how happy I am regarding this feature of the game. When I saw this written up, Guild Wars, come on. This is the thing which every good MMORPG must have. This is mandatory because within faction, there are guilds, there is competition. And these things are giving to the game something special, something really additional, something really special. Because there will be some faction versus faction things. Actually, lots of things in Ilion will be faction versus faction. However, these things, guild versus guild, this is amazing. This is absolutely, at least for me, from my perspective, I play MMORPG games a long time now. This is really something amazing. Then we have here a guild citadel. This system I have seen in some other MMORPG games. In short, that I have studied already this. Basically, your guild leader can bid to take some stronghold, some fort. And then if your guild leader have managed to win in that bidding, you will get some benefits for your guild. There are different kind of benefits which you will have there. You can buy some research things which will then help you in that specific area where that stronghold is, so in the area of that fort. So this is not kind of PvP thing or battle thing, this is kind of bidding thing, right? So who wins in bidding get that fort, and with that fort, with that stronghold, you will get some specific benefits. Also, regarding specifics of these benefits, I have studied this translation, and yeah, some things are clear, like teleport to your own stronghold, 30 minutes cooldown, that's one of the benefits, but some things are absolutely not clear what are the benefits. However, benefits are there, they are regarding lots of things, and you can buy actually some benefits for gold, or maybe even for that guild coins. Then we have on the end of this video, I just want to show you additionally here, other community systems. Yes, this is, of course, you will have in Ilion, like in any other MMORPG game, you will have a friend list, so you will be able to add specific people on your friend list, and that way you will be able to communicate with them better. And also you will be able to make, here shown a little bit of user interface, you will be able to make some parties, some for the raids. Also normal, this is MMORPG game, you need to make some groups, some alliances, we can say, parties, raids, to go to do different things together. Not only within your guild, we are talking about guilds in this video, however, in general, right, in the game. So this is shown here a user interface, how it's looking when you are making a party, when you are making some raid for some world boss, and it's also showing here how it will be shown on the party search channel. This is the end of the video, guys, and this is end of the post which GM can make. However, let's scroll up and let's recap. Come on, can you see? Did you see these amazing things which will happen regarding the guilds in Ilion? I must say I'm really fascinated how they have developed this system. We have guild wars here, right? Which is amazing. We have guild benefits. Your guild leader can research specific things, maybe life skills. Check this. Your guild leader can research different things, and all depends what is the goal of your guild. If you are more in PvP, your guild leader can research things which will help you in war. But if you are more into life skills or hunting, your guild leader will research these things more. But not only that, you have that super, super great items. Check this list of the items which you can buy for that special, let's call it now, guild coins, in-game currency. And these items are wow. These items are really amazing. And with these items, you can help your guild members and to yourself in the battlefield and in general. Really amazing items. And in general, I must say, these guild missions, yeah, let's not forget about that. I was talking about that in the start. Also, one of the many interesting things which you will be able to do in Ilion, together with your guild members, you can do some guild missions, and you can get benefits, different rewards from that. As you can see, guild system in Ilion, highly developed, really nicely developed, and from the informations we have so far, come on, this is really, really amazing, and I hope we'll be able to enjoy very soon in this not only guild system feature in the game, I mean, we will be able to enjoy in this game in generally, I hope, very soon. So far, we don't have any information from Korea regarding the release of the game. We had just a while ago another closed beta. Now I'm following all informations from Korea. Maybe we get some release date finally for Korea and for Southeast Asia. And of course, after that, for Western regions. And if I see any kind of new information regarding the release of the game or some new in-game feature, you will find out about that on my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching the video, and if you like it, subscribe to my channel to see more videos in the future. See you soon!